Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome into the LakersNation.com podcast. I am Trevor Lane. You can find me on Twitter at Trevor_Lane, over on Instagram and Threads now as well, which is kind of hanging on by a thread, I guess. It's slowing down a bit, but at Trevor Lane NBA. Anyway, that's where you can find me on those locations. But today we're going to break down what the Lakers rotation could look like in terms of the minutes, what we could see out of their lineups and all of that. So it's going to be a lot of fun. Can't wait to dive into the new look Lakers and what a real rotation could look like for them next season. Joining me, he's awake. It's Sean Davis. How are you doing, Sean?
Ironically enough, I am pretty tired. I'm still on the West Coast. So like the East Coast in me wants to go to sleep pretty soon, but I'm good. I'm ready to talk about this Lakers rotation, which I've had a couple of cracks at already, and it was very polarizing, and I'm ready to do it again. So let's go. Pretty excited.
So what that means is if there's anything you agree with or disagree with in here, those of you watching on the Lakers Nation YouTube channel, let us know in the comment section. What do you think we should change? Is there a rotation that you don't like? Fire off your thoughts in the comment section down below. And don't forget to hit that like button as well. All right, Sean, you're at the wheel here. Let's just jump into it.
Sweet. Let's dive in. Shout out to this wonderfully made template that I found. I think the biggest thing that is going to be the conversation of the summer, I think you have four starters in my eyes, because with this roster, I'm praying that Anthony Davis is the starting five. I don't want to see AD at the four, personally. From my vantage point, that means there's four guaranteed starters. It's D'Angelo Russell, in my opinion at least, Austin Reeves, LeBron James, Anthony Davis. I think the biggest conversation point that's going to come out of this is who starts? Who's the fifth guy? Is it Jared Vanderbilt or is it Rui Hachimura? And before I kick to you, Trev, I think it's more or less, I don't think it matters who starts necessarily. I think at the end of the day, Rui's probably going to get more minutes. Actually, not probably. I will bet money Rui's going to get more minutes than Vando, just in this rotation and the next season even. So with that being said, who do you think should be that fifth starter?
You know, I've been saying all along that I think it's going to be Rui starting. So, who do you think is going to start? Are you in agreement, or do you think it's Jared Vanderbilt? Because I'm torn on how I want to do this.
I think it's Vando for now.
So let's go with that, and let's do it because we saw just the other day, he's working out with Phil Handy. Let's say that we're living in an optimistic world where Jared Vanderbilt is now shooting 35% from the corner three. Fingers crossed, let's get there, Vando. And we'll slot him into the starting lineup because he's knocking down those corner threes now.
All right, cool. So with that being said, we can start to fill in some of these roles. Austin, shooting guard.
D'Lo would be so mad at you for calling him a point guard.
What do you use Vando as, a small or a power?
Let's just put him at the power forward. Let's just pencil him in there.
Jeez, not that. Jeez, I did again. Okay, center, bad podcasting aside. There we go, cool. How long do we want that group to kind of run together?
So that's where we got to start figuring that out. So that's our starters. It's D'Lo, it's Austin, LeBron, AD, and then Jared Vanderbilt in there as well. So let's start there. I would think you're probably going to see a sub within the first 6 minutes. So let's say that group gets the first 6 minutes of the game.
Cool.
Okay. And so this chart is breaking it down minute by minute. So you can see a minute by minute breakdown of the first quarter of the game. That's what we're looking at here. So right now you've got that group staying on for the first 6 minutes. Maybe you could say somebody would sub out at the 7 minute mark or something like that, but just kind of a rough estimate. So from there, we're going to see subs. And I know Darvin, he's going to mix up his substitution patterns, but who do you see coming out first? I think it's probably going to be
LeBron. And Vando.
Yeah. So LeBron comes out. Is it just a straight swap of LeBron and say a Taurean Prince? Is it LeBron for Rui Hachimura?
I think it's Rui and Taurean at the same time for Vando and Braun.
Okay, so let's do that then. Let's do the two wings come on, and then we would probably see another sub after 3 more minutes. We'd see another sub at the 3 minute mark, where I would think at least one of D'Lo or Austin would come out.
I would argue right now that D'Lo comes out at the same time as Braun and Vando. D'Lo comes out, and then you go Gabe, and then
okay,
around the 9 minute mark. Because how I've done like my previous rotations is that essentially when Austin's not on the floor, that's Max Christie time. So I would say like 9 minutes. Because I view Cam Reddish as a three. This isn't really even a Max over Cam Reddish argument. Yeah. This is what I view Max Christie as. I think Max is probably the backup two right now. So okay, that's the case. Personally, I probably ride Austin until around 9 minutes. Let Max maybe close the quarter and start the first couple minutes of the second quarter. I don't know how you think about that.
Yeah. I like that. So you've got your first sub halfway through. Is D'Lo, LeBron, and Vando all going out? And then right, Rui, Gabe Vincent, and Taurean Prince all coming in to join Austin Reeves and Anthony Davis in that grouping. Then you have Max Christie coming in as that secondary sub coming in when Austin goes out. So he's getting those back up 2 minutes. Is AD playing the entire first quarter?
I was just about to ask you that. Would kind of imagine, I would think, do we want to shorten LeBron's minutes by like a minute or two? And then that way we can allow LeBron to close the first quarter and then keep bringing Jackson Hayes in. That way you don't have
that's one, not a bad idea.
Yeah.
I like that. So chop a minute off of LeBron, have him sub out, and it'll be, let's say it's Rui coming in for him. So add a minute to Rui, since that's probably our priority, is to put more minutes there for Rui. And then to close out the quarter, have LeBron come back with like 2 minutes to go and AD go out with like 2 minutes to go or something like that.
Cool.
And then Jackson Hayes would also come in at that point.
Right. Who do we want really quick? I'm assuming Gabe Vincent closes the quarter, right?
Yes. Yeah. Gabe Vincent closes the quarter.
Okay. So right now, last 2 minutes, we got Gabe Vincent, Max Christie, Braun closes the quarter.
Jackson Hayes
closes the quarter.
And would it be Taurean Prince? You'd just run him all the way through, right?
Yeah, probably just run Taurean all the way through and then give Rui his minutes back to start off the second quarter. Sweet. Okay, so first quarter's done. Right now, I think this is probably the best bet. I think it's going to be like around 10-man rotation. Mm-hmm. Maybe in the playoffs, it drops to 8 or 9 with the two omissions. Right now, I think Jackson Hayes would be the first guy that gets cut. And probably Max, honestly.
Okay.
Cool.
Okay. Second quarter. Let's get into it.
Second quarter. Do we want to keep AD on the bench for a little bit? Give Jackson a little bit of run?
Honestly, I think you just take the same group that closed the first and keep them on for the first probably at least 3 minutes of the second. So we can just transfer that over.
LeBron.
So again, that would be that group that we're talking about right now, just to kind of rehash for everybody. That group is Gabe Vincent, Max Christie, Rui Hachimura, LeBron James, and Jackson Hayes. Right? And Taurean Prince came out?
Taurean Prince closed the first quarter.
Oh, he closed.
Quarter.
So it was Rui came out and Taurean Prince
coming
closed.
In. That's right. Rui's coming back.
Yeah.
Okay. Got so it. Rui, give Rui a little bit of extended minutes. Cool. Now we're... The problem with this is, though, do we want to run AD the rest of the quarter?
I think you probably have to. What's AD's minutes at in this scenario? He's 10 minutes already right in the first quarter. If you, I think Jackson Hayes, his stint would need to go to at least the 8 minute mark of the second. So then you've got AD on pace to play 36 minutes. If you can get Jackson Hayes to the 6 minute mark of the second quarter, so you're giving him an 8 minute stint, then you've got a couple of minutes of leeway with AD in the second half to play with. So I think that makes some sense.
Okay. Right around now, I think we're about time to bring D'Lo back in. Same with Austin.
Mm-hmm.
So D'Lo, let's just go to that 6 minute mark until we get AD back in. Shoot, that's the wrong one. Wrong one, right? No, right one. Cool. So we can bring Austin back in. Austin, in all likelihood, would probably finish out the quarter.
Do we want to have some minutes, and maybe this could be in the third quarter, where Austin is the point guard?
That is – what would that look like? That would, I think I played around with that. It would be like Austin – the lineup I put together was Austin, Max, LeBron, Rui, AD.
That really would probably be it. We're talking about a situation where AD comes back in, and D'Lo, he's only got 6 minutes, though, D'Angelo Russell does so far. So, and we've already given, I think we can keep it like this with Austin as the two for now. But I do think at some point we're going to see Austin get some minutes where he's the lone ball handler on the floor.
Yeah, I think, unfortunately, right now at least, the only pathway I truly see where Austin gets significant point guard reps is if an injury happens to Gabe or D'Lo, knock on wood, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
Because like I think if you give Austin point guard minutes, I think you're taking away from D'Lo and Gabe Vincent minutes, honestly, because I think – we're probably going to end up splitting their minutes anyway, whether it's 28, 20, 20, something along those lines, right? So
when it's all set, when the dust settles, it'll probably wind up being split up. Okay. So where do we go from here? We've got Jackson Hayes. We're halfway through the second quarter now.
Jackson Hayes has played 8 minutes.
Okay. Jackson Hayes has played 8 minutes. So that's it for him. That's it. That's all we're playing him in the first half. He's not getting more minutes than that. That's maybe even a little bit optimistic on his minutes. So let's leave him there. AD closes out the quarter at the center spot. There is no AD Jackson Hayes overlap. Maybe that's something we can try to work into the second half.
Okay.
Give
Bron his rest here. Probably come back to close like these final five. So let's just fill in our closing five really quick. Austin probably closes out the quarter. I think 6 minutes break is probably fair for Austin, right?
Right. That puts him on pace for a 36 minute game. But if I would assume that of D'Lo, Vincent, and Austin, Austin's going to get the lion's share of the minutes.
Right.
Running through him quite a bit.
Right. Who do we want closing the quarter? Is it Gabe or is it D'Lo?
I think it's going to be, honestly, game by game, I think it may change, but for this exercise, let's just have D'Lo close out the quarter.
Okay. Okay. You probably just have to give him the rest of the quarter then.
Yeah. You'd probably just have to give him the rest of the quarter. And then we can feed some extra minutes to Vincent in the rotation in the third.
Yeah. And we can always go back and make edits when.
Yeah,
we got
once
the
we
rotation.
See how it all breaks down. Okay. Yeah. So now.
Probably Rui in that closing lineup.
Yeah, Rui closing out as well.
Okay. So we could probably align Rui's minutes with Bron in terms of that closing.
And then Vando would get that gap there between the Rui minutes, that four-minute run in the second quarter.
All
right. Right, because we've got to have a power forward in there.
Okay.
And then who's your three? Is it Taurean Prince during that stretch still? That's a little awkward because he would come out and then back in. Yeah, you can do it.
You can do it. I think.
What if we took that as an opportunity to get a little creative?
Cam Reddish?
Maybe it's some Cam Reddish minutes get mixed in there. That's what I was thinking.
It's like a 4 minutes, two 4 minute stints, two 4 or 5 minute stints.
Yeah. Yeah. Just to kind of give him the reps.
I think this is the one way you can maybe get a non-LeBron lineup to survive. A non-LeBron and non-AD lineup to survive is if you just get some maybe spark plug scoring with Cam.
Mm-hmm.
And then you still have Austin, you still have D'Lo. You have Vando for some defense. It's not ideal, but it's a 4 minute stretch. And actually, really, it's only a 3 minute stretch because Cam's last minute, technically, AD's gonna sub back in.
Right. And, you know, there's maybe, you know, if you really wanted to ease the burden here, or if you wanted to make sure AD and LeBron are on the floor at the same time, or one of them is on the floor at all times, you could always chop some of Cam's minutes or chop Cam's minutes completely and extend LeBron another minute and extend AD going the other direction a minute or two and have AD and Jackson Hayes overlap a little bit.
Yeah.
And then you're running the two big lineup that we've heard a little bit about. But anyway, that's future rotation. This is kind of a base, you know, safest guess run through right now. We can play around in the future with what does it look like if Jackson Hayes and AD are on the floor together, you know, things of that nature.
So first half complete. These are okay. The minutes we got. You got D'Lo at 15 for D'Lo, a little bit high, okay. Honestly, that I was probably expecting. Gabe's at 9. Austin's at 18, so like we said, right on pace for that 36. Max is at 6 minutes, which is about fair.
Mm-hmm.
Vando's at 10, which again is probably about fair. This is Torian Prince. He's only at 6. Cam's at 4. Ruri's at 13, which is probably about right, maybe a bit more. Braun, 15. No, that's not Braun. Yeah, that is Braun. That's okay, LeBron. My bad.
AD Braun. And AD is at 16.
Yeah. So go ahead.
So that's about right. And really, when you're looking at this and you're seeing, oh man, only 6 minutes for Torian Prince. Yeah, I mean, feeding a few minutes to Reddish kind of cannibalizes some of Prince's minutes.
Right.
But early on in the season, I think we're okay with finding out what they've got in Cam Reddish.
Yeah. Oh, that's cool. I didn't know this. So like your lineups, this is about right. You got your starters, you got your closing lineup. That's probably how it should be.
Right.
That lineup's actually kind of intriguing.
Which one? Vincent, Reeves, Prince, Rui, AD?
That's kind of intriguing.
That is.
I kind of like that.
That is. That is an interesting lineup. Any lineups that you look at, you just go, oh, no, that does not work.
Like I said,
Vincent, Christie, Braun, Prince, Hayes?
That's
not bad.
This one? That's Rui.
You're talking about this one. That one's not bad.
But we'll see. The fact that that's probably the worst one is probably a good sign. If that's the worst one.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think the non-LeBron, non-AD, D'Lo, Reeves, Reddish, Vando, Hayes. I think in an ideal world, if you're going to run that lineup, you probably need Rui in place of Vando. Because you'll need the scoring punch. Do you agree with that? Or do you think you can get away with it?
I think we could do that, actually. You would just basically be... then you might as well just give these minutes. I think the only way to make it feasible... sorry about my long-windedness in answering the question. I think the only way you can get that to work is if you gave Torian Prince... essentially, you gave Torian Prince these minutes right here. This 3 minute Ruby stint, let him like keep going.
Flip it.
And then, yeah, you just flip it essentially. Torian takes this 3 minute stint to start the second. And then Ruby would just take that stint, take Cam's stint. I think that's the only way you could get that done.
Let me see that lineup again. What is that? It's D'Lo, Reeves, Reddish, Vando, and Hayes. And maybe if we're looking at Reddish as if he settles into a scorer role, maybe it's okay. Hayes, I'm not counting on for offense. Vando, I'm not counting on for offense. My issue is D'Lo and Reeves, all the pressure is on them to score. If Cam, it all depends on the big question mark on the team, and that's Cam Reddish. Can he be a scoring threat for the Lakers? And if the answer is no, then you really have to, or not a a very dangerous scorer. He's more of just a spot up guy. I think having Rui in that rotation would make more sense. If the answer is yes, though, then I think you can get away with it, especially if we're, again, living in that wonderful world where Vando can hit the corner three.
I prefer to live in that world.
Okay.
My favorite. All right, cool. So if that's the case,
for now,
we'll leave it for now.
Yeah. Okay. All right, let's get into the second half.
I think you probably have to cut D'Lo's stint a little bit short in the third quarter so we can make up for some of the Gabe Vincent minutes.
Sure.
Unless you wanted to go two guard or like both of them together, which is probably going to happen at some point this season.
Darvin Ham is still coaching, right? Can we make a five guard lineup? Is that possible?
Do we even have five guards?
D'Lo, Vincent, JHS, Austin. There it
and
is.
The boy Hodge. And
Max Christie. Throw him out there.
Yeah.
Oh, they're all five. All five. Darvin right now is getting so excited.
For five guards, that's actually not bad size-wise.
That's not all things considered. Okay, so we're chopping D'Lo's minutes here a little bit to start the third quarter. He's only going 4 minutes into the third. I'm assuming that's in order to put Vincent in.
Yeah. Okay. How long do we want to let Vincent go? Because I think that depends on who do you want to close. Are we going to go with the same thing where D'Lo closes the game too?
Yeah, I think we close the game with the same group that closed the half, while understanding that in reality, Darvin's going to pick who is it that's playing the best between Vincent and D'Lo, and that person's going to close.
Okay, cool. I'm just going to quickly add in that then.
And this may be our opportunity right here. Once Vincent needs a sub, if we don't want to tack on too many minutes to D'Lo, who's already at 24 minutes right now,
Austin
got to get some Austin at point guard minutes. And again, not something we have to do, but maybe some leeway here towards the end of the third, beginning of the fourth to play with some things. Although that's also the danger zone where we saw so many times last season, we're praying the Lakers can just hang on in that deadly stretch between the end of the third and beginning of the fourth. So we'll see how this all comes together.
Here, let's do it this way then, in terms of the guards. D'Lo, the problem is, I think it would most likely be maybe just, that's tough. Hold on, let's fill in some. You would probably have to give Austin an early break too then.
Mm-hmm.
Like Austin subs out around the same time, honestly. Shoot, I didn't want that. Hold on, is this Vando? This is Vando. So let's just add in like this the first 4 minutes or so. Bron.
What do we want to cap LeBron's minutes at?
I think in a perfect world, LeBron capped at like 32 minutes.
Okay. Let's keep that number in mind as we're building this out.
All right. We're at 24 right now.
Okay.
So you have eight more minutes to play with.
8 more minutes of LeBron.
Okay.
All right. So we're through the first 4 minutes of the third quarter. And then we've got Gabe Vincent subbing in for D'Lo. Any other substitutions we want to make there?
If you want point guard Austin, you probably have to go Max pretty early too in the third.
I think I want to make sure Austin's on the floor to help transition the last couple of minutes of the third and into the fourth.
Okay, so you want Austin in there.
Yeah, so let's sub out Austin.
Get him in back here and let him kind of... You can honestly have him do that. Have him play point guard here to end the quarter.
Yeah.
And then... To start the four, if he could go back to the two for a sec, and you give D'Lo a quick stint, maybe. Hold on. How would that work? Let me see. D'Lo, quick stint. You give Gabe a quick stint.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's not bad.
Yeah.
That's in the end, you've got D'Lo playing 27 minutes and Vincent playing 18. But we'd have to remember, like, in reality, those final five minutes of the fourth quarter, they're going to go to whichever one's playing well. So in reality, it would be you could very well wind up with D'Lo plays 22 minutes, Vincent plays 23 if Vincent gets the nod closing that particular night.
Right.
Right. Okay.
Cool. So Vando, make sure. Yeah. Vando's at 14.
Okay.
Okay. So essentially, what do you want that second lineup to be in the second, in the third quarter? Do we go back to Max and let Max play the two for this stretch right here?
Yeah, I think we do. I mean, he's only at 6 minutes. I think he probably needs to be in the double digits by the time the dust settles.
Huh. Or is this your opportunity with the big gap? Because I think, honestly, if Austin's the point guard, Max probably has to be your two.
Mm-hmm.
So I was going to say, let's just, I don't know, give him a 6 minute stint, get him to 12. So you have two more minutes to play with. Is this your opportunity to steal a couple more D'Lo minutes? Because that's a, what, 8 minute, no minute stretch, and let him.
Yeah, that's fair, especially because I think we are going to see some mixing and matching. Like, right, our rotation right now has no D'Lo and Vincent on the floor for each other or at the same time. They've just been tag teaming. So, yeah, right. Just call D'Lo the two and Vincent is the point guard and off we go.
Okay.
Okay, that makes sense.
That makes some sense. And then D'Lo comes off. Gabe stays the one. Max is his sub. Cool.
Great.
How long do we want Vando to go for? He's at 14 minutes right now.
So the trade-off with Vando is always, well, let's look at that group, right, that we've got coming in. So it's Vincent and D'Lo. So you're sacrificing a little bit of size by having Vincent on the floor and D'Lo, and D'Lo doesn't play super big. I could see where it would make sense to extend some of Vando's minutes there and have him go into the quarter another couple, like, I don't think they're going to sub LeBron out at like the 4 minute mark of the third quarter.
Right.
I could see LeBron and AD are probably both going to go for the second half. Especially, I think we need to make sure that LeBron and one of LeBron or AD are on the floor at all times.
Right.
So yeah, I'm looking at that. And then you go, when LeBron goes out, you go to say Rui. Maybe it's a Rui and Torian Prince sub with LeBron and Vando going out at the same time.
Would you rather have AD get his break before the quarter ends or after the quarter ends? Meaning he finished, because I think in the second half he'll probably ride the whole third, or would you rather him not ride the whole third, maybe sub out 10 minutes and then start the fourth, but get like that middle break for like 2-3 minutes or whatever?
Yeah, I think we go with the latter. I think we go with the latter there.
So let him get 10 in the third?
Okay. Yeah, for consistency's sake, because that's what we had him do in the first.
Okay, fair. And then, so that means Braun checks back in here. And then AD, have him start the fourth? Probably.
Yeah, you either have him start the fourth or you have him come in at like the 8 minute mark and he's going to play there the whole rest of the way.
It's a long time with no AD.
That is a long time with no AD. Is it better to put him in at the start of the fourth and then play a couple of minutes, 3 minutes, and then he gets a 2 minute, say, rest, and then he's back in to close?
I think that's what I would rather do. And I think that's the most likely based off of how they kind of did it last year.
All right, let's roll with that.
So AD, get him like the first, and actually maybe even give him like a 4 minute break.
Okay.
Or like a three. We'll go three.
There is a 35 minutes. I think that's the top, right? Especially during the regular season. That's the most I'd want to see out of AD for minutes.
Yeah.
35. All right.
Okay.
LeBron's sitting at 26. We've got some minutes to play with here.
So
he has to be in those minutes that AD is out. So that's a long stretch to close the game for LeBron there. But he's got to be. You can't not have him in there.
Yeah. You have three more minutes if you want to give him to 20. Or you can keep him at 29. Maybe give him one more so he can hit 30. But I don't know if LeBron's at 30 minutes.
He's at 30 right now. With that. He's at 30 right now.
So, let's see. So, that's no Braun. Yeah, no Braun. That probably means you got to go Rui for these non-Braun minutes.
Yep. And
Okay, perfect. So Rui, if we ended Rui's minutes right now, Rui's at 27.
That's maybe a little high, but probably about right. Now I would imagine, though, as we look through this, like with Rui that high in minutes, Torian Prince's minutes are really suffering as a result.
Torian Prince is suffering.
He has not gotten in the second half yet at all.
Yeah. Well, we have some spots. So Torian's right here. Rumor. So Torian could just be the Vando sub.
Okay.
Honestly, would you want to ride him to the end of the quarter, honestly?
Torian Prince? In place of who?
So, like, essentially, hold on, let me do that. So, cool. If it looked like this.
Oh, that makes sense. Okay. I see what you're doing.
Rui is technically the Vando sub. Torian Prince is therefore the LeBron sub, but LeBron comes back in for Rui to close the quarter. And then in this gap of minutes, Torian's back out there.
Okay. So let me see. What's the closing lineup at the end of the third then? Then it's Gabe Vincent. That's Austin. That's Austin. Max.
Torian.
Torian Prince. LeBron. Jackson Hayes.
Does it pop up over here? What did we say it was? Gabe Vincent. No, that's not one.
No, it's Austin is playing the point there.
Right here.
So it's Austin, Christie, LeBron, Prince, Hayes.
It's not bad.
They'd have to get stops. I think that's it's asking a lot in terms of LeBron and Reeves awesome. Creating, but
yeah,
it's not terrible. And then you're starting the fourth, which I think is another critical juncture, with D'Lo, Austin.
You probably have to go back to Vando to start the quarter.
Okay.
Do you think Rui Vando works?
That's the challenge. Now you're looking at Rui Vando together because LeBron's coming off to start the fourth. But it's not just Rui Vando. It's Rui Vando and AD on the floor together, along with Austin and Reeves, or Austin and D'Lo, I mean. That's interesting.
We've done it actually already. When did we do that?
It's somewhere in there.
Somewhere. I don't feel like looking.
Okay.
Okay, so does that just mean we go back to it then?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think we do. Again, we're living in a world where Vando can hit the corner three. Like, that changes everything, right?
Okay, cool. So there's Vando's minutes. We need to... Okay, honestly, you just got to get that extra minute. Cool.
Okay, no, we'll wrap up with some of this other stuff in a minute. Okay, so who needs to come in there? That 3 minute stint.
You need some two guard minutes. Is that do you want to go for some reason ridiculously large and go Cam Reddish at the two for 3 minutes? And then then I could take that minute off and give Cam his 4 minute stretch still. Is that something we've tried to do?
Yeah. I think in the fourth quarter is not where you're going to experiment with stuff like that, but
it's either that or you give that 3 minute stint to Max, my bad.
To Max Christie. And then he's at 15 minutes for the game.
Yeah.
Which honestly, based on how he played in Summer League, it's just Summer League, but
nope. Trevor Lane said it.
I mean, I've been talking about it. You look at the moves the Lakers made and the moves they didn't make. I think they are big believers in Max Christie. So as Max at 15 minutes, I don't think that's crazy.
As they freaking should. Okay, well, if that's the case, we got to get rid of these four Cam Reddish minutes.
You're not going to give them the obligatory THT just for fun minutes in the first half?
Just for fun?
Yeah.
Nah. Torian Prince?
What is this right now? We're at a 10-man rotation right now?
If you take out the Reddish minutes, then it's 10. With Reddish, it's 11.
It's an 11-man rotation right now? Yeah.
You count Reddish.
Yeah, let's stick with a 10-man rotation. So pull those Reddish minutes.
Torian Prince.
Torian Prince picks them up. Yep, that makes sense.
Ah, crap. Okay. That's the non-LeBron minutes. I remember that now.
Oh, and we were going to rely on Reddish to provide a little bit of scoring punch.
Hold on. We can maybe get away with it. Rui would have a pretty long closing stint, but he had a pretty significant break. But you could maybe rock it out this way.
Crap, let's see.
Jeez, this is
so Rui's going to be the four. I mean, and this is all nominally, you know. So Rui is playing the final 9 minutes of that quarter. Which may be doable. It's a lot, but.
Yeah.
Okay.
This lineup isn't great either. Gabe, Max, Braun, Vando, Jackson Hayes. Again, in the world where Vando can hit corner threes, that works. But if you want to be a pessimist, you could really pick apart that lineup. It's 3 minutes, so maybe. Or you could just give those minutes to Taurean. But, like, you're really feeding Taurean. He's already at 20 minutes now.
Yeah, that's a lot. Okay. So let's see. You've got Taurean. Yeah, and especially because that would give him a straight stretch through.
Okay, this, hear me out. This would kind of be small.
Okay.
But, shoot, you can't do that either. So I was going to say, what if you went both point guards, Max, Braun, Hayes, but that's, you know, really small.
You know what's really going to happen, though, Sean? This is where we're going to see all three guards on the floor together.
Honestly, this is your best time, but then also we'll be playing the entire second quarter.
Right, right. Yeah, that's the problem. He's not going to actually do that. But at some point, you know, that's going to get mixed in. You know, it's it's going to get thrown in there. Okay, so you're starting the second quarter with a lineup that may not be ideal with Gabe, Max, LeBron, Vando, Jackson Hayes. And
I mean,
that's a lot on Gabe and LeBron to score the basketball. I would think in an ideal world, Hayes and Vando probably aren't sharing the floor together. Right?
And I guess we could probably do it this way, where maybe you do it where Braun just gets another break, but you get extended Braun minutes. So it's like Braun here, Braun here, Braun here.
Okay.
80 still gets his break. Braun gets his. He gets an extended minutes crunch. Jeez, 80's at 38 minutes now.
Yeah, that's too high. That's too high. We got to chop that down.
Okay. We can probably get away with a couple more Braun minutes because he's only at 30.
Yeah, that's where you're going to tack on some LeBron minutes.
So now he's at 32.
That's pretty good. AD's at 36. LeBron's at 32. And then what does that lineup look like to start the second again? We're back to Vincent.
So now we're at Vincent.
Max.
AD. I need to take away. Because now, for some reason, there's six players on the floor. Well, Braun's on the floor, and we're going to Rui anyway. And cool. Just give Taurean Prince these minutes.
Yes. Yep. Exactly. There you go. There you go. And then it's AD, Taurean Prince, Christie, Gabe Vincent. And you got to add somebody with them.
Ando?
Why not?
Are you advocating for Russell Westbrook to be back on the team, Trevor? Is that what I'm hearing?
No. Definitely not. Definitely not.
Ah, crap. Okay, same problem. There's six guys over here. These are Taurean Prince's minutes. Okay, well, we'll probably nix Vando's minutes.
Yeah. Is that right? Is that Vando at 26 minutes there?
That's Rui. I meant to say Rui.
Okay, so Rui's at 20. Okay, got it. So Rui's at 26. Okay. Okay.
This actually looks pretty all right. You got D'Lo at 29. Gabe at 18. Austin at 34, Max at 15, Vando at 18, Torian Prince at 20, Rui at 26, Braun at 32, AD at 36, Jax Hayes at 12.
And I think to some degree, this kind of really reflects what coaches are going to do when they're sitting down and making up their rotation, because you're going to make up your basic rotation. You're going to have it. And of course, coaches need to be able to adjust on the fly, but you're going to do stuff like this and you're going to get to the end and then you're going to go, wait, I don't like this. I don't like this. I don't like this. And you're going to go and you're going to adjust and you're going to shift through things. So like kind of, I was feeling pretty good. And then we got towards the end and then suddenly it's like, wait, but there's this problem and this problem.
Yeah.
And then you go and solve, and that can sometimes domino into some other issues. But ultimately, look at where we wound up. D'Lo, Reeves, Braun, Rui, and AD get 10 minutes. That same lineup with Vando in there instead of Rui gets 9 minutes. Those are the two lineups that you probably want getting the bulkier minutes, and sure enough, they do. Gabe Vincent, Christie, Braun, Prince, and Hayes, that group gets 5. Maybe that's a little bit of a surprise that group winds up being the third highest.
But it makes sense that your next four are with Gabe Vincent at the point. That makes sense. Yeah. And I would even argue that this top lineup is going to depend on which point guard's playing better.
True.
Because that's your closing lineup.
And then you've got D'Lo. You've got Reeves playing the point in one rotation, along with Prince, Hayes, LeBron, Christie. So Prince and Christie are going to have to shoot the ball pretty well in the perimeter in that lineup. But I do like the defensive potential of that grouping.
We're really relying on those guys to shoot well, because actually it looks like all of Christie's minutes are next to Prince. Vincent Christie, Braun, Prince Hayes, Rui. But this lineup, I like this lineup a lot.
I'll tell you, I actually kind of like I do like that one. That's a good one. I do kind of like, if I flip it and I'm not focusing on offense, Reeves, Christie, Braun, Prince, Hayes, and we know that Hayes actually has some skill defending on the perimeter. That lineup is switchy as hell.
Yeah, that's so switchy. And
that's interesting.
I think an even better version of that lineup, can I type over here? I think a better version of that lineup would be if you could somehow get, like, hold on. Well, let me edit it. If that would be Reeves, Christie, Prince, Vando, AD. If you just want to talk about pure switchiness, we're switching 1 through 5.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
The very least 1 through 4, and let AD just protect the rim still.
Okay, is there anything that you look at on here, minutes-wise, where you're saying this guy's getting too many or this guy's not getting enough?
I think Gabe is the only one where I'm like, I would like to get him some more minutes. I think without taking away any of D'Lo's minutes, your best bet of doing that is to get more of these two guard pairings, which we've only did for a 2-minute stint with two separate lineups, technically, but similar groupings. It's just one was with LeBron, one without, but similar lineups. But again, like I said, I think, depending on the game, and I think come playoff time, Vince is going to get way more minutes. We're talking Vince getting 20 to 25 minutes in the playoffs or in a game where he's playing really well.
The rotation is going to be cut down come playoff time, for sure.
Maybe you could argue Torian Prince, a couple minutes too much, but shrug.
I like this. I think this is a fairly realistic lineup. I think that a rotation, I know there's a lot of different ways that we can do this, but in terms of just kind of playing the middle ground and trying to make some safe choices here without going crazy and saying, hey, let's throw in a super small lineup. Let's do a super size line. And that's fun. We can do stuff like that in the future, but just kind of like hey, what could a realistic rotation look like? This probably isn't too far off, but this was, this is a good exercise to kind of go through this and get a sense of what these rotations could really look like for the Lakers this next season. I like this.
Yeah, that was fun. And I think the biggest thing to take away that we've already talked about a ton, especially post-free agency and post-draft even, that this Lakers team, I think, really added positional versatility to where you're like, okay, we can either get super switchy, which honestly, the Lakers had a really good defense last season, especially post-trade deadline. But there's just a certain cap on how elite or even maybe generationally elite they could have been defensively. And I say generationally elite because of how good Anthony Davis is on that end, because you didn't have a ton of versatility position-wise, right? Mm-hmm. Where D'Lo's not a good defender. You're relying on a bunch of Vando minutes if you do want to get switchy defensively. Now I think you have, if you want to get switchy, just throw Gabe Vincent in there. He came from the switchiest scheme in the NBA by far, and the most complex defensive scheme by far. Max is going to get more minutes. You can get a little bit switchy there. Torian Prince, I think, just as another big body, could be fine. Braun, when he ramps it up defensively, especially come playoff time, he can switch. Not quite often, I might add, but he can do it. AD is probably not where he's best at. And maybe that could also be another thing, Trevor, where you start thinking about the rumors that have circulated saying the Lakers want to play both bigs with AD and Jackson Hayes. AD could probably switch on the perimeter a little bit more. That's not where he's at his best, but you can do it a little bit more because, and vice versa, because you have Jackson Hayes behind him. Or that's honestly where Jackson Hayes is at his best. When he's switching on the perimeter, he gets to guard and use his length and his ridiculous wingspan. Oh, guess what? You have Anthony Davis right behind you. So go ahead and press all the way up. So I'm super excited, really more, Trevor, defensively about how good this team can be, especially seeing what how good they were with, all things considered, a pretty bad defensive roster. Not bad, but like not a great one, if that makes sense.
Yeah, you know, I think that this I think if there was anything to adjust, it would be to put in some AD and Hayes minutes side by side, just to take the Lakers and what they've said at face value, that they are going to play them together at times. And so putting them together, I think maybe the next time we'll do this, we'll try to mix that in and throw that wrinkle into it. But for now, I think this is a pretty good start. But you know what, like, Lakers Nation, we haven't done this a lot, like really get deep into the weeds of building out an actual rotation. We've done plenty of roster builds, but rotation is something we haven't done much. So let us know in the comment section, did you like this? As you kind of got to see our thought process as we broke everything down and took a look at what the rotation could really look like and tried to weigh the pros and cons of everything. Did we go too fast through it? Too slow? Give us your thoughts. What did you think about this segment? Let us know in the comment section down below right here on the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. But Sean, this was a lot of fun. I think we came up with, all in all, considering we were just kind of shooting from the hip, pretty good rotation.
Pretty good for a now 47-year-old at the time of its release. Yeah, that's right. Definitely 47. I should grow the beard out for a 47-year-old.
That's right. You get the salt and pepper beard going and be right there. You're right there. All right, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us. Make sure you do subscribe to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, stay safe and see you.